Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My presentation today addresses the use of resources and resource maps in order to reduce the risk of chronic kidney disease for agricultural communities in El Salvador. One of my intentions of this short presentation is to bring into our mind that risk mitigation resources are not limited to resources out of the health sector. My name is Matthias Grössler. I'm a PhD student and research assistant at the Institute of Mathematics at the University of Koblenz-Landau. In my research, I work on mathematical modeling and the use of GIS for logistic optimization of medical resources in public health services. First of all, the presentation gives an overview on the aims and objectives of my project work. In the first topic of this presentation, I will present general information about resources, resource maps, and the correlation between risk and resources. The next issue of this presentation is an approach of how to reach agricultural communities with risk mitigation resources. Afterwards, I will show a short example of resource optimization with available preventive resources. The presentation is completed by a summary and an outlook to further work. This project is aimed at mitigating the risk of chronic kidney disease for agricultural communities in El Salvador. We are working on concepts in order to decrease the exposure of agricultural communities to agrochemicals. One approach to achieve this goal is the delivery of a spatial decision support system, and in my case, using logistic resource optimization. The result from the spatial decision support system and the logistic optimization will be provided to decision makers. This includes any decision making level, from health administration to doctors and nurses, and also to risk exposed people. First of all, a definition of the term resource. In general, resources are a stock of supply of money, materials, staff, and other assets that can be drawn on by a person or organization in order to function effectively. According to risk maps, resource maps are a spatial and temporal distribution of resources visualized in a map. Resources for risk mitigation, in this case for the risk mitigation of chronic kidney disease, can be divided by the point of time of application into preventive resources and corrective resources. Preventive resources are used to maintain a healthy organism. Therefore, they are used before a person gets ill. Examples for preventive resources are all kind of healthcare information in different kind of media, like videos, pictures, articles, and so on. Also, protective clothing like face masks or protective gloves is in the category of preventive resources, as well as precision farming provided via videos or training. Corrective resources are applied when a person is already ill. Those resources are the classic healthcare resources like healthcare facilities, medical personnel, devices, and medicine. If you compare preventive resources to corrective resources regarding their disposability, in most of the cases the disposability of preventive resources will be much higher. Therefore, I will mainly focus on preventive resources in my further presentation. Now I want to have a look on the relation between risks and resources. As Jörg Rapp already showed in his presentation, the risk through agrochemicals is characterized by three factors: the toxicity of the agrochemicals, the exposure rate, and the uptake rate for the agricultural community. As I showed on the last slide, the resources can be divided into preventive and corrective resources. The relation between risks and resources has a spatial dependability. Depending on the GPS location, the risk and resource situation changes according to the following factors: the dominating crop and its cultivation method, the applied agrochemicals, which can differ in type, amount and frequency, and the working conditions of the agricultural community at the GPS location. As risk and resources vary spatially, they can be visualized in risk maps and resource maps in a spatial decision support system. This map information could be transferred to mobile devices. To initialize the questioning process, the application on the device has to send the geolocation to the spatial decision support system via its GPS sensor. Then the spatial decision support system would give back the risk and resource information. This information is tailored according to the user profile as risk and resources for the agricultural community depend on the conditions of the location of the user. In this example, only one risk and resource layer is visualized. In reality, multiple risk and resource layers for each specific risk and resource would be necessary to reflect the actual situation. The single layers could be combined in the geographic information system of the spatial decision support system finally. Having showed how resource maps can be created and how they are related to risk maps, I would like to show you on the next slides how agricultural communities, and in other words an exposed person, can be reached with preventive risk mitigation resources out of a spatial decision support system. The spatial decision support system includes, amongst others, preventive risk mitigation resources like health information. Furthermore, a support algorithm is implemented which is able to perform GIS resource analysis. The information channel or delivery chain can be different for each agricultural community. One possibility is an information channel via ICT. Here, a mobile device like a smartphone can access directly to health information like videos or health applications. But also the access with lower technological devices via speech control is possible. One possible speech control system is the open source Simon from Peter Krasch. Another access channel for agricultural communities are social workers or public health workers. They can be the link in the delivery chain which transfer ICT information, provide training or verify the actual situation with the information in the spatial decision support system. No matter which kind of channel is used by the agricultural community, it can always send information back to the spatial decision support system as crowdsourcing information. If they use an ICT channel, they send their information directly back via their device. If they use an information channel via a social worker or a public health worker, information can be collected and implemented into the spatial decision support system via questionnaires. This slide visualizes a possible setup for the information channel. Regional IT services are linked to a central spatial decision support server. The regional IT services can then be accessed by the agricultural communities via mobile devices by those who have the necessary equipment. The other agricultural communities have to face the last mile problem, and therefore they use the information channel via a connecting person. A public health worker contacting the people directly in the agricultural communities closes the last mile of the chain. In El Salvador, the INS could perform this task. A public health worker is able to perform medical consultation, disease monitoring, control of drug taking, and partially also medical treatments. Additionally to public health workers, also a social worker can address the last mile problem. The social worker could either work with an adaptive questionnaire, what Melanie Platz explains in her presentation, or provide training to the agricultural community. With the questionnaire, analysis of the actual pesticide application workflow could be performed. Furthermore, the actual risk and resource situation at the agricultural community could be verified. The provided training can include a workflow optimization of the pesticide application process, or videos, or education about precision farming. Now I would like to show you an example of the optimization of preventive available resources. It's a fact that people in the agricultural communities have to use agrochemicals in order to achieve the crop yield which ensures their survival. The following of mixing rules can optimize the used agrochemicals and thereby lower the exposure and uptake of the exposed person, as people often use more agrochemicals than necessary. The visualization of mixing rules increases people's awareness for this topic and therefore support exposed persons, especially illiterate people. In this example, just the proportion of water cans to agrochemical cans is illustrated, but this can already be enough to optimize resources but still ensure the necessary crop yield. Looking closer on this example, we can determine the optimized applied resources. First, the special decision support system provides the crop health information and the related mixing rule for the specific agrochemicals. Then the smartphone is used to visualize the video or picture of the mixing rule. Afterwards, the social worker has to fulfill several tasks. First of all, he has to validate the risk and resource situation provided by the special decision support system. Then, he has to deliver the mixing rule information to the agricultural community and also support the community with the application workflow, like mixing procedures or drinking habits during work. Finally, the amount of applied agrochemicals is optimized. To sum it up, the main statements of this short presentation are: the preventive risk mitigation resources are not necessarily out of the health sector, we use only available resources, and we can optimize their use for risk mitigation. Furthermore, the constraints of the optimizations are: resource optimization should be performed without reduction of crop yield, we reduce the exposure and uptake of agrochemicals, and the agricultural communities have to be reached. This very important point, that the agricultural communities have to be reached, can be performed in different ways, of which I mainly focused on two in this presentation. One, through ICT channels, and two, connecting the last mile with the support of social or public health workers. The next step in our research project would be to set up a pilot project for the optimization of preventive risk mitigation resources for agricultural communities in El Salvador. The single phases of this pilot project could be as follows. The first step would be to request the current status in the agricultural community. This includes the workflow for application of agrochemicals, the risk situation, and the preventive available resources situation. Then, a concept of risk mitigation using preventive available resources would have to be developed together with the agricultural community, with the restraint not to reduce the crop yield. This could happen in the framework of a living lab, as shown in the presentation of Marlene Hesselmann. Afterwards, the concept would have to be implemented. And finally, the status after the implementation has to be requested via a questionnaire or a mobile device. This suggested living lab is only one part in a huge living lab necessary to reach our goals. Thank you very much for your attendance. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to ask them now in the discussion time.